which is fertilizer type, then plant density. How the two of them come together to affect crop yield. That is two-way ANOVA. So after you've done ANOVA, just like Doc said, ANOVA will only tell you that there are differences in the group means. If it is four groups, it will only tell you that there are differences in the means. If it is 10, it will only tell you there are differences. But how do you know where the difference is coming from? Or from which pair is the difference coming from? So you move forward to do what you call the Brooks-Hawk test. And the Brooks-Hawk test is basically a combination of multiple t-tests. So you have a lot of Brooks-Hawk tests, but the common data. So this is the p-value for the F-test. Usually they add an R to it, so this is the p-value. So you can look at the p-value. It's actually 7 times 10 to the power negative 4. So if you take the decimals in, you get something like 0.1237. So that is the p-value. So you can compare this p-value against the level of significance, 0.05. You can also compare to 0.01. You get it? So if you compare, you can see that this is less than all levels of significance. And so what will be our decision? Our decision is to reject the null hypothesis. And what is the null hypothesis for ANOVA? My brother took us to the null hypothesis is that the difference in all the means is equal to zero, or there is no difference in all the means. That's to say, mean 1 is equal to mean 2 is equal to mean 3. Here, the fertilizer types were 3, so you have 3 means. So that's the null hypothesis. So we are rejecting that. So let's